Yeah, that's right. That's right. Well, everybody, welcome to Positive Power, everybody. We appreciate you guys tuning in to us. And, hey, share the file. Share the wealth, y'all. So everybody find out what's going on in the world, the gospel industry. So we got some great guests coming on tonight. I was hoping Miss Ursa was going to come on tonight. I didn't see her pop in yet. So they're getting ready for their stage play on Saturday. So that's exciting. I like stage
play. Yeah, I was hearing about that. That sounds like it's going to be really nice.
Yeah, they said it's really, really funny. Real funny. And I was hoping she was going to come in and tell us about it. But if you want to hear a little bit about it, we actually have our interview on our website. So if you go to positivepower21.org, look for on the Newsom Awards interview. You'll see her. Actually, it's her. Her and Tanya. Tanya's standing right there with me. That's the interview. It's kind of midway because I think we had a couple other interviews before hers. But it sounds like it's going to be nice. I'm looking forward to it. Yeah, yeah. So what's going on with you?
Nothing. I kind of had one of the days like you did. You know, I worked earlier today and I had to do some things for a couple of clients and did that, ran some errands, and now I am here on the Jerry Royce Live.
Amen. Amen. So did you have an event this weekend?
What did I do this weekend? Oh, yeah, I actually did. Friday, a friend of mine, she is a relationship coach, and she has, like, these events every month. Mm-hmm. So she was doing a regroup for the year, for next year, getting some new ideas. So she invited me to that along with a few other people. So that was really fun, talking and about relationships and progress and things like that. And what else did I do? I had some other events. So I had a lot of stuff going on this weekend.
Yeah.
I don't know why. I can't remember.
Because the day's Wednesday.
Everything that I did. This weekend, but it was really fun. I went to a opening for a girl. She just opened up her own retail store. So
oh, wow.
She had a grand opening. I went to that. It was a really nice space.
Is it a boutique? Is that a boutique?
Huh?
Is it a boutique?
It was a boutique, yes. It was a boutique close to us for plus-size women.
Oh, wow.
And really fashionable clothes, really nice clothes, nice outfits.
Yeah.
She had a really nice event.
Yeah, that's cool. That's
it's
cool.
Called the Noel, I think it is,
yeah.
Here in Cleveland.
Because I noticed there are a lot more designers out there now, you know, catering to that market. Because I know Khloe Kardashian, I think she has jeans that's catered to that industry, right? Called American Girl.
Yeah, I think she does.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, so I think the designers
it's a market that's out there.
Yeah, it is. And it's funny because you would have thought that would have been a niche market years ago, you know, because, I mean, just face it, you know, everybody's not going to be skinny and everybody's not going to be heavy at the same time. Everybody's going to be in between, floating back and forth, you know, because everybody changes once they get older. And, you know, it's what it is. It's just a melting pot of different type of people, body types and everything. So
yeah.
I'm surprised.
That's so true. And women's clothes, you can go in one store and wear one size, mm-hmm. and you can go into a total another store and be two different sizes different in another store.
Yeah,
so
sure.
If you a person who know how to get clothes for whatever size, woman, that is true to size, mm-hmm. you're going to be pretty successful.
Yeah, that's right.
As long as you have good customer service.
And that's why some people stick to
it. It looks like that's what she has.
Yeah, and that's why some people stick to like that particular designer for everything, because then they can just buy it right off the rack or mm-hmm. online. And like me, I try on a pair of pants and I make sure I keep that style. I put the sticker actually in my closet so I remember the size, the length, and the design, the style. And I'll go online and order some mm-hmm. more pants. If I say, oh, I really like the way this fit. And I'll order a couple of more colors and, you know, long as I can go with it. Because right now I had to change pant size because
mm-hmm.
since I started this new medication, I seem like I lost maybe 2-3 pounds. So my wife was like, yeah, I'm getting tired of looking at these pants hanging off of you. So I had to go get some new pants. And went and got some Hager slacks.
How do you get new pants or a tailor? Good tailor.
I know. But I was at the point where it was going down too much. I mean, I do have a couple suits that, you know, I used to wear that size years ago. So I still have those. So, you know, it's what it is, you know. It'll be wintertime soon. I can wear long johns.
Well, it's a good problem, Gary. You're getting healthier.
Yeah, that's right.
Know?
That's right. No more. Can't be carrying 230 around no more. Can't be big guy. I was big guy. Can't be big guy no more. So that's what it is, you know. Got to do what we got to do. So, and it was funny. I was talking to Dr. Kelly today. Dr. Kelly called me. He's really excited. Him and his wife are still pumped up after that show. And he told me that he actually been walking. He said he been checking out the walking chat with Batman 5K. And
what?
Yeah, he said he been walking around his mansion, though. He hadn't gotten outside yet. I said, go outside, man. So people see that light, man. See that light that's on right now. He said he's just so happy after doing that show. They excited, man. Like, you know, a new awakening. You know, so they coming on board. They about to join the Positive Power family. Yeah.
Really?
Like,
wow.
Yeah.
Congratulations to both of you guys. That's
going to
be awesome.
I know. It's exciting.
They're a really good team.
Yeah.
That'll be really nice.
Yep. It's going to be good. Plus, he has really good connections, you know, with people that's involved with the NAACP. You know, talking about civil rights. And we need some good programming like that. You know, we do. We really do that.
Mm-hmm.
And then we reaching. You know, we reaching. So I'm excited to have them on board. Them. Happy Hour Pastor Jack is doing well. They come on tomorrow. So you guys want to hear a really good podcast. Good team. They gel very well. Good chemistry. It's four of them, four podcasters, and they from different parts of the country. I think they all went to college together, if I'm not mistaken. I think that's how they became friends. But I'm going to try to get Pastor Jack and Sierra here. I'm gonna try to get them on camera soon. So I'm gonna be working it out with them real soon. As soon as we get into September and to start get our new schedule together, you know, kids back to school and all. So we're looking forward to that, getting them in the studio, do some things. And we're gonna have Sophia Jacobs back with Done With Debt. So we're gonna be back to programming, talking about, you know, how to budget your money, how to save, get ready for retirement, get those kids in the couch. She got really good tidbits on how to maneuver one paycheck, you know, make it stretch. So, and I know she's going through some things right now with a car repair. So, I think she actually got two cars that's broken down. So, we'd be anxious to see how she's getting around that, you know. All right. Well, don't see Miss Ursula, Miss Battle coming in. But again, anybody in the Baltimore area listen to the show? Again, she got two shows on Saturday, 1 and 6, 3 o'clock on Sunday. That's the 26th and 27th. Go to battlestageplays.com. And we're really excited about her. We was talking today, and we're going to do some things together. Because, you know, I always wanted, you know, I never wanted to be Tyler Perry on the producing the stage play, but I wanted to be him when it came to bringing stage plays to the masses. You know, that whole journey he took from, you know, building a stage play to making it a television a movie. To a television show, I like that process he was involved in, you know. And that's what made him a millionaire, maybe billionaire soon. So I'm looking forward to talking to her. She's really interested in learning about the industry. All right, what else we got? Oh, I forgot about my man. That's right, James Deshay. James Deshay, Wealth Dads. Is that right? WealthDadSystem.com. That's right. I was rushing today. I had to go marketing and take my daughter to work and then check down my mail and try to promote all in a few hours. So anyway, James Deshay.
Yeah, that's a lot of stuff.
Yeah, there was a lot going on. And plus, I got off work a little late because my daughter, I didn't know she had to work today. She never worked that many days in a row. But I was thinking, I said, well, that's right. College kids are going back. So that's opening up more days for the high schoolers. So they're getting their time now because the lady probably didn't think about hiring while these kids were transitioning, you know, back to college. So she actually worked Sunday through. I think she worked every day this week. Yeah.
My God. Wow.
Me too. Yeah.
Ooh, work. That's a lot.
Yeah. Let me see. Tomorrow, Thursday. I'm not sure if she worked tomorrow. I think she may be off tomorrow. That'd be a good thing because I need to work late myself so I can get ready for Friday. Yeah, Friday. Patrice, we got a lot going on this weekend. I don't see, let me see if Metro Point is in here yet. Nope. Don't see her. No, her, she probably didn't read the directions. And I told her, we can't take, what's them phones? We can't take PCS. And what's the other phone I said I couldn't take? T-Mobile. She probably got one of those. And she probably trying to call in, probably can't get in. Let me see.
All that don't know, don't wonder why she can't get through.
Yeah, I'm going to check. Let me check on her message real quick while we talk about what's going on the road trip this weekend. All right, road trip this weekend, y'all. Let me make sure she's good. Yeah, she's supposed to be coming on at 9:30. I hope she didn't forget. Because we're on the same Eastern Standard Time, I believe. All right, while we wait for her, I'm going to just hit her real quick, because I know she's busy trying to get this award show thing going. Well, anyway, road trip this weekend. Batman's on the road. Going to Chesapeake Bay, over in the Bay Area. We're going to be at Cambridge, Maryland with Live Again, the Art Bar. They're going to be entertaining a gospel artist. I don't know who it is yet. I'll find out. Supposed to find out. I think he did send me a message who it was, but we're supposed to have a meeting tomorrow, but I think everything is a go. But the good news is we're going to be there filming and streaming, so you guys get a chance to see a new artist that I don't even know anything about. So that's going to be exciting. That's going to be over in Cambridge, Maryland. 7 o'clock. Yeah, so tune in, Patrice. I hope you can tune in. You know, I know you got stuff going on Saturday, but Saturday is 7 o'clock. We'll be streaming, and it'll be available for later on-demand watching. Then, on Sunday, we're going to be... No, my bad. Friday. I'm sorry. Friday is 6:30. Okay. Is she on the line? I don't see her on the line. She told me she on the line. She always tell me that. Oh, she must be on the line. Man, she on that. She got an invisible phone. Oh, my God. She's something else appointed. Well, anyway, she blocked me on my big system. I see her on mute. She got me there. We're going to be with you in a minute. Well, anyway, Friday we're going to be with Michael Tornado in Baltimore. J. Nicole from Echoes of Glory. Fox Sports 1460 Harrisburg is going to be hosting an event. You guys know J. Nicole Jones, big time independent gospel, beautiful music. I hope she performs. He's going to perform. Hopefully Anthony Avery will be there because they do have a collaboration together, him and Michael Tornado. 418, this is a CD release party. Then on, so that's going to go on tomorrow. We're going to stream that and film it. Hopefully we can get some interviews. Then on Saturday, we're going to be over in Cambridge, over in Chesapeake Bay. Then we're coming back over to outside of Baltimore to Windsor Mill, Maryland. And we're going to Windsor, Maryland, I think that's what they call it. We're going to be with Ursula Battle on Sunday around, I think her play gets started around 4 o'clock, I think. We're going to be filming. I'm probably going to film a little bit. I doubt if I stream it, but you get a chance to catch the reaction of the people coming out of the play. So we're going to be able to get some interviews and everything. So that's what's going on. Jerry was like, a.k.a. Batman, on the road. All right. How'd that sound? Can you hang? You going to be hanging with us online? I hope so.
I would try. So, you know, you're going to be pretty busy. I'm going to get in there somewhere.
Yeah. And the good thing is that event would be over, you know, around 6, so be able to get some rest that evening and get ready for Monday. So that's going to be great. So Double XI is on the road again, but, you know, I don't have to go that far except for over to the Chesapeake Bay. That's a 2-hour drive, but I'll be able to stop off at my parents' house and chill out with them. You know, they had wrote a newspaper article about this area in Maryland. They call it the New Hamptons. I thought that was so interesting. I'll tell you guys a little bit more about that another time. Very nice area if you got the money to live there. All right, let's get appointed on the line. I know she got some stuff to talk to us about, but let's play her song real quick, and we're going to come right back to her. So she got a song called Opposite. You know, we've been playing this. We've been rocking this for a while, so it's one of my favorite songs, too. Here we go. Opposite by Mr. Appointed, CEO of Spin Magazine and the Spin Awards.
Living life on the edge of expectation. Ever since my life took on a new direction, I've been living life contrary to condemnation. Because God, you had mercy on me. You revealed your son in me. Opened my eyes and now I see. To live my life more abundantly. I'm walking by faith. Not by sight, in your power and not my own might, and I live to die. so you can increase and I decrease. You're wonderful. Yes, you are. Tremendous. Yes, you are.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Exceptional. Yes, you are.
And I see, but I see so different.
I'm Larry W. Robinson, host of Gospel Updates, your gospel entertainment news report. And you're listening to Positive Power 21 Christian Radio with Jerry Royce, live worldwide.
That's right. You tell him, Larry. That's right. You listen to Jerry Royce live worldwide, Positive Power, XXI. All right, y'all. The next voice you're going to hear is going to be Mr. Appointed. She needs no introduction. What's going on, Mr. Appointed?
Hey, Batman. How you doing?
How you doing tonight? Acting crazy. That's all.
I know. I'm gonna see you and I'm gonna see you and Patrice at 2 o'clock. I'm gonna catch you guys. When I see you guys, I'm gonna catch you.
You gonna get it?
I got hands.
Hey,
I got hands to lay on you.
I'm like looking
hey, girl,
at my
pretty
my
good.
Cue. I'm looking at my cue. I said, "Where is everybody? Is this just Patrice?
I know.
It was you. You was invisible. You didn't show up. How you
I know.
Do that?
What about the other person? Are they there or what?
No, Miss Ursula, she must be still rehearsing. Hopefully she called in because I text her to call in when she can. So let me remind her. Let me check on her because I know she's trying to get ready for this play. You know what that's going to be like. You got your big event coming up. So are you ready?
Yes, good lead in, Jerry. That was awesome. Yes, the Spin Awards. The Spin Awards honoring Christian Gospel Radio. Yes.
So you excited?
I'm excited, but I ain't ready, Jerry. I was just talking to somebody today. I said, we cannot be 3 weeks away from this and not have everything settled. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. Every T has to be crossed and every I has to be dotted and every bow has to be tied.
So you still, what, 6 weeks away, right?
Well, about 8 weeks away. And 8 weeks. 5 more days, it'll be 8 weeks away. Yeah, but it's still like, that feels like ultra close, you know?
Yeah, man, that's exciting. We're so excited.
Put an event and you know the vision for it. You know how it's going to be perfect. It gets to, it's a lot. It's a lot of anxiety to it. But when that day comes, it's going to be so glorious.
Praise the Lord. Because, you know, we're putting in like hours upon hours. I can't even be, it's like, I can't even count the hours that we're putting in. And, you know, all this going to like unfold within just a few hours, right? Like we put in all these hours and then it's going to unfold within a few hours. But the Spin Awards happening on October 28th, 2017, Lithonia, Georgia, 3D Complex, 2244 Panola Road. That's what it's about. That's what's happening. Where we're going to honor those who spin the gospel message. It is such a great time.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be like a reunion for a lot of people. Now, I don't know a lot of the Atlanta DJs in that area. The names you're throwing out there, I'm going to try to study those guys and, you know, listen to them when I can. That's exciting. Man. I got a question for you, though.
I mean,
I forgot. We got to get the show started. All right. First question is, who is Mr. Appointed? Tell us. Who are you?
Oh, who's Mr. Appointed? Mr. Appointed is God's child out here on these streets, on these main streets of the world, trying to share the, you know, not trying to, actually really sharing the gospel message. So I'm just, you know, that person that's out here using whatever means and tools that I can use to help people see the light, you know, see that God saves, Jesus saves.
Amen. And we met you a couple of times in person, and you're just so genuine. We love you to death, and, you know, it's like we've been knowing you forever.
I know, huh? It's like we're long-time homies, but yeah. It's all good, you know. And I thank the Lord for the opportunity to, you know, just be able to come on and talk about the Spin Awards. It's not about me this time. I'm not even singing, Jerry Royce. And Patrice, I'm not even singing for the Spin Awards.
No problem. I'm sure somebody want to take your place. That's
I am not. You will not see Minstrel Appointed singing offices or call me or anything. You know, I'm not going to be up there doing any kind of singing whatsoever. So it's because really and truly, the Spin Awards is all about really giving honor to the people who are spinning the gospel message, to those unsung heroes. And at the same time, above all of that, like bringing glory to God's name. That's what I'm putting in almost every post. You know, glory to his name, glory to his name, because ultimately that's the goal.
That's right. All right. So, Patrice, you joined
in. Well, I remember the first time I seen you perform and the one time when Tina kind of snuck up on Jerry. And
I know.
You're a great performer, and of course I love your songs. So is it weird not performing? I know you're... while you're not performing, but is it weird not performing this time?
You better believe it, Patrice. You better believe it, girl. You better believe it. You asked the serious question right now. You asked the real truth right there. Yes, of course, it really is odd, you know, because I'm putting together like this great, great program. Well, I shouldn't say I, because it's like a whole bunch of us. So let me take that I back. Forgive me. Mm-hmm. But we're putting together this great program, and It's to me, any artist that gets a chance to be a part of the Spin Awards, to get in front of people that are in radio and to help honor these guys, it's like an awesome privilege, because radio is going to be there. The people that have been spinning the music, the people that have been blessing the creators of the music as well as the listeners of the music, these people are going to be there. And so you get to be in the midst of all of that, and you get to show them, you know, like, hey, you know, I stand with you, and just, you know, kind of pay forward. So it is definitely weird not being, you know, because I'm an artist, and it's like, I'm an artist and I'm not an artist that's in it, but it's all good, because I've got a greater purpose in this, and that's to make sure that present the program in a way that has integrity, and, you know, because I think it's just like uncool, like to have a program, put all this stuff together, and then have myself up there on stage. So no. Somebody say no.
Hey, y'all lucky I can't sing. I'll be up there on my own stage. MCing, singing, and dancing.
Yeah, I'm just for the music, because I sure can't sing a note.
You're just so humble. So
and so, you know, like when some people, like, let me just say this real quick. There are a couple of people that are presenting that are artists too. So I feel, I mean, I know how it feels because they're artists.
Mm-hmm.
Let me try to plug them. Let me try to find the names and make sure, because I don't want to say anybody's name wrong. But I'll plug them in a bit. But they're artists too, and they're not going to be singing either. So I know. I know the pain.
You know the pain.
I think that's great that, you know, you understand, because you want to, you know, give honor to these people with your voice like you usually do. But it's important to see that when God has a vision for you, you know, sometimes you may not always be able to do it in the way that you think you're supposed to do it. You kind of just had to be obedient to God and do it in the way that you, you know, in the way he say.
That's right.
So I think it's wonderful that you being obedient to him and honoring these people
that day.
Or those days.
Thank you.
Yay.
Thank you, Patrice, because I really and truly believe that the spotlight, it needs to be just like on them. And I think it diminishes it if I'm up there, because then it might be interpreted as, oh, you did all this so you could sing. You know, so no.
That's funny. But, you know, hey, it's what it is. But that's cool of you. Now, Minstrel, you've been wearing you really busted on the scene really strong. I mean, you came really strong. I mean, I'm not going to say you came out of nowhere, but you just showed up on the scene. You have a television show. You got radio programming. You're on global networks. You're winning awards left and right. Every time I turn around, I'm hearing your name 2-3 times. Now you're hosting. Well, let me back up. You own the Spin Awards magazine. Not Spin Awards, man. Spin Magazine, CEO of that publisher. And now you're taking on this award show. How are you doing it? Where you find this energy from?
Well, I'm finding that energy from, like, this purpose fire. I've learned, Jerry Royce and Patrice, I've learned that purpose fire will have the world move out of your way. And so it's like when you have purpose fire, when that's burning, when there's something that you have to get, you know this is something that you have to do, then, you know, God just, he has a wealth of resources and power to supply you so that you can just, like, keep doing what you got to do, you know,
because right.
I'm telling you, naturally, I wouldn't be able to do this stuff, but I'm on fire because there's something that God has called me to do. There's things that he has for me to do. Not that, you know, I'm so special, but this is my assignment.
Supernatural. That's powerful. All right. Thank you for answering that question.
Thank you for asking.
<All right>. You got it, Patrice.
Wow. Yes, I sure do. So I was, you know, I've been looking at your page and seeing, you know, how the awards is coming along and seeing people that have been talking about it. So this is going to be one big historical event. Where did it get, what inspired you to put this on?
Well, another one, Patrice, man, you are so good. You got to help me with my interview questions. I'm going to start calling you and saying, I'm supposed to interview the Walls Group tomorrow, so I'm going to need some help, Patrice. I'm going to have to inbox you so you can help me know what to ask the Walls Group. But what inspired me was just like, at first it was just like all about me wanting to like say thank you to people that have, you know, like been spinning my music, because I'm like this country girl from the backwoods of Texas, and I don't have this big budget, and I don't have a bunch of big names and, you know, a bunch of folk behind me and stuff like that. So it's like I'm like David up against Goliath. And just to have people who've opened up and to spin my music. Now, when Opposites and Call Me, when those songs first came out, it was on like a whole bunch of stations. And for me, it was a whole bunch. Maybe for my dad, nothing. But for me, it was a whole bunch of stations. And I just wanted to say, well, thank you, because some of the nicest people that I've ever met in my whole entire life in the industry have been people who are spinners, you know, announcers, hosts, and stuff like that. So I wanted to give back. But somewhere along the way, the Lord showed me that, hey, this, you thought you were doing this on, like, on your terms, but this is really, like, my thing, and I have you on assignment. So it's like it changed everything for me, knowing that God has me on assignment.
That's right. Awesome. God is good. God is good.
Yeah.
Now, I was checking out your website, your Facebook page, and I saw that the place where you're going to be hosting the Spin Awards, what is it called, the 3D... Help me out.
Complex.
It sounds,
yeah, the 3D complex.
It sounds awesome. It sounds like one of those football stadiums I've never been to. You just dream about. Tell us about it. Tell us about this place.
Well, the 3D complex used to be known as the Legacy Theater, so it actually used to be a place where people would go and do movies, and it was owned before by, I can't remember Russell's name, last name, but a guy named Russell. He owned it when I first found out about it. He owned it, and then he eventually sold it to Pastor John Elmore. And so now it's the 3D Complex, and it houses his church, and it houses like other churches, but it also serves as a conference center. So it's a place with theater-style seating. It's got like a big old screen where you see the projection and all that stuff. And it's really a great place to host the Spin Awards. I tell people, you know, of course, it's not like, you know, high. It's not like the highest high-end venue. It's not like the lowest low-end venue either. So it's somewhere, you know, moderate and somewhere that I think people will have a great appreciation for. So it's going to be in a beautiful setting. We're really doing our best to bring things together to give people that awards experience. That's what we want people to feel, that awards experience.
Yeah.
And so I think it's going to be a great place for people to dress up, show up, and send praises up.
Yes. I like it. I like the way it looks. It looks impressive to me. I'm good. I'm looking forward
I'm good
to
too.
It.
I was like, when I went in there, I was like, oh, because it has some upgrades. I was going to take it before the upgrades. I was like, oh, man, you guys have done some stuff around up in here.
Yeah.
You know, and I was just really grateful. And I can't even begin to tell you, Jerry, how Patrice, how it felt like to just, like, sign the paper and get it, you know, like to actually, like it was actually on. Like, this is on. This is real. This is happening.
I know.
And so I know, huh? It's like really, it's honestly still surreal. But it's an awesome time for radio because there's no other awards program that I know of that celebrates strictly. I'm not talking about just having a little category, but I'm talking about strictly radio and radio announcers. And I know there's a couple of folks or so that I'm talking to, and they're people that want to see in radio, that want to see this go to its highest heights because radio doesn't have this. Christian gospel radio doesn't have it.
That's true.
So we want to put this thing on the map and make it stick.
Yeah, I love it. I love the whole idea because, you know, the gospel, the independent gospel artist, and of course the mainstream gospel artists, they have their thing. But where else can you watch a program where there's even going to be mainstream radio guys? Do they have a program like that for mainstream guys? You know, like, you know, the urban radio people? Do they have a show?
No, I don't know of anything. I heard that they used to have something like the Gospel Music Workshop of America. I heard that they used to have like a time where they honored radio, but to the best of my knowledge and everybody that I've talked to in radio so far has said that there's no other platform like this for radio.
Oh, wow.
So it's the first, and I'm sure there'll be other things that follow afterwards, but it's the first of its kind. And so we're trying to slap everybody with a bang and, you know, take this thing to like as many levels as possible so that we can impact people with the gospel message. Let people know, like, hey, the spinners count too, man.
That's right. That's right. I love the idea, and kudos to you. All right, we got a few minutes for to play another song for you because we have another guest coming up, but we really appreciate you stopping by and sharing it. And, of course, we want to have you back as we get closer to the Spin Awards. Just remind people about this great event. And, shoot, man, I'm excited about it. You just don't know. I wish it was next month it was going on.
Not me, Jerry. I ain't ready. Do not come next month's been awards because we will be in trouble. We still need some more presenters and people that are looking for artists to be presenters. We still could use that and a few more volunteers. But mostly we just need, you know, some people to do some presenting and let me see, what is it? I'm looking for some dancers, you know, some dancers. I'm looking for dancers.
Right.
But other than that, you know, everything else is lined up.
Awesome.
And we'll be good to go.
All right.
By the time the thing happens.
Well, before you go.
So, okay.
did you feel the power? Did you feel the power, Mr.
Feel
Appointed?
The power.
Feel the power.
Feel the power.
That's right. Well, thank you so much for coming by. But look, if you got one more thing for us before we let you go, because I know you gotta get back.
Yes,
to work.
I just wanted to say www.thespinawards.com, October 28th. In the Atlanta, Georgia area, Lithonia to be precise, 2244 Panola Road. Please, you guys, show up. Let's support radio.
That's right.
They support us. They give us that good gospel music. Let's show them the love that they've been showing us.
Amen. Amen. I'm excited. And so let me know if there's anything you need us to do as far as promotion concerns. So we'll talk to you offline, okay? We'll be in contact.
Okay, awesome. Right. Love you guys. Thank you, Patrice. Don't forget to inbox me so we can talk about what we're going to ask the walls. What we're going to ask the walls for tomorrow. I'm serious. Inbox me. I love you. Bye-bye.
Some help.
Bye.
All right, y'all. Let's take a quick break before we bring Miss Michelle Brooks Thompson on. So we're going to listen to one of Mr. Appointed's song called Call. It's one of my favorite songs, Call Me. I know Opposites are a big hit, but I love Call Me. So here we go with Call Me by Mr. Appointed.
But he delivers. Listening to PositivePower21.org with Jerry Royce.
All right, everybody. Thank you for tuning in. We'll be right back. We just finished talking to Mr. Appointed. We appreciate everybody tuning in and shouting out to Mr. Appointed online. Appreciate you guys. We heard from Colton, and we heard from John E. Ross, and Sean Ray Price. I still got this Sean Ray. Sean Ray Price used to be backup singer for Mariah Carey and George Michaels and P. Diddy. She's out there. That's right. We following your 5K walking chat. That's right. You and Jeffrey Moore doing your thing. I just heard from Dr. Kelly. He about to start his 5K walking chat. Well, not quite a 5K, but he about to start his walking chat. Anyway, you got to get that physical fitness in, everybody. That's what we all about. We pushing good health and wellness. Don't forget about www.lose5pounds.com/5days.info. That's right, Women's Day, Ms. Daynette Watson. That's right. All right, coming up next is Michelle Brooks Thompson. She has a new sound in gospel music. Michelle Brooks Thompson, an award-winning independent gospel recording artist from Springfield, Massachusetts. As a child, she was recognized and claimed by all as a child prodigy. Because of her ability to sing and play the piano by age 9, Michelle's tone and vocal power is frequently compared to the late musical icon, Whitney Houston. She has been often referred to as Whitney Houston of gospel music. In 2002, Michelle pursued her passion for music by attending the prestigious All-Women's College in Massachusetts, Holyoke. Okay, I tried. Where she majored in vocal performance and piano. In 2000, she received a Bachelor of Arts in Music and was accepted to Boston Berklee College of Music as a candidate for the well-known and respected Performance Diploma Program. All right. Michelle chose to pursue her own new steps in music independently and deferred her acceptance to Berklee. Since that time, she has crafted and refined her singing ability, which can undeniably be ranked with some of the major gospel and secular artists of her time. All right. Let's bring her out, y'all. Let's talk to her. Michelle Brooks. All right, we got Patrice Jackson back. We got Michelle Brooks Thompson.
Hello.
Welcome to the program. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you, Jerry?
I'm awesome. We're joined by Miss PJ, Patrice Jackson from Ohio. She's my co-host tonight. And we're glad to
Hello,
have you, Michelle.
Hello, Miss Patrice. Hello, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. I'm excited to get to talk with you all tonight.
Yeah, we're impressed with your vocals. Lovely. So I tell you what, we're going to ask the first question. We're going to let everybody have an opportunity to hear you, even though we have been playing your music on the show. So the first question is, who is Michelle Brooks?
Who is Michelle? Well, I am a singer, songwriter, keyboard player, mother, wife,
a lover of God, woman of God, and I'm just out here trying to pursue my passion and live the purpose that God has given to me. And, you know, I've developed this name and an identity of, you know, Michelle who sings, and that's been my part of my identity all of my life. And I really enjoy music and using it to reach people in a positive way. And that's really who Michelle is.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you for answering the question. So we're looking forward to talking to you tonight. Awesome. All right. So, Patrice, tell you what. You want me to start the music?
Yes.
And then, because I know I just sent you the list, so the bio. So you want to do that? Let's play the music, and then we get right back to Michelle. Cool? Sound good?
Okay.
All right. All right, here we go. Michelle Brooks Thompson, I Am Triumph.
The battle may be raging, trouble all around. You're crying out to Jesus for a way out. Hold to your faith, finish the race. He's already made your way of escape. You are triumphant, you are a winner. You're not defeated, you've already. You have a victory. You're not a failure. You've only just begun. If you only knew God has great plans for you. Don't give up now. Press on anyhow. Cause the greatness of God lies within you. You are trying.
Said your victory.
You're not defeated. You've already won. And it's through Christ Jesus you have the victory.
This is Brandon Royce, and you're listening to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide on PositivePower21.org.
All right, that was Michelle Brooks Thompson. Beautiful music. I Am Triumphant. Beautiful, beautiful music. All right. Was that all you? You was playing all the instruments and laying everything.
No, I was not doing that. I don't have that skill like that. But no, I have been blessed to work with some amazing young artists who are passionate about music. And my producer, Jerome Pitts, really brought the song to life. And so I have to give credit to him, as well as my band and my singers who support this ministry.
Awesome. Thank you. Thank you. All right. My question is, so much talent, you know, and you chose to stay independent. Why that? Was it that, you know, mainstream was no interest, or, you know, what was the business decision?
Well, honestly, I definitely want to be assigned to a major gospel label. And that is my extreme endeavor to accomplish at some time in my life. But what has happened, you know, since my venture on The Voice and being out there on so many platforms, there's sort of a struggle with being approached by secular labels. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the sad part is, you know, sometimes I receive more support from my secular platforms than I do, you know, my church counterparts, if you mm-hmm. will. And so, you know, knowing that my passion is ministry mm-hmm. and utilizing the gift that God has given me for his glory, it makes, you know, my journey a little bit longer than what it might take for some, because down the line you tend to compromise because you want something and you're waiting for it and it's not coming, so you take the next best thing. And it's not that I haven't had the opportunity to go mainstream and be on a record label, but it's just the type of music that I've been asked to sing. And, you know, my husband and I talk a lot about it because he always reminds me, you know, remember your purpose, remember why you sing, and not be, you know, enticed by what the secular labels offer you, because you know that God is giving you a mission and a purpose. And so that's why I remain independent, because the right opportunity to sing gospel on a major level has not been presented to me yet.
All right, just plugging away. All right, I know Patrice got a good question for you. Ready, Patrice?
Yes, I am. So first let me say your song is beautiful and your voice is amazing. So I wanted to say that because I almost didn't get it. I had no questions. I was into the song. So I wanted to say that. And then also, I commend you on what you just said about how you're sticking to your principles and your beliefs along the way, even though you've been getting so, you know, different opportunities, you know, your purpose. And I would like to ask you, with knowing that and, you know, being in such a, having this creative side to you and have this gift since, like I think you said, 9 years old, how do you feel like that shaped you along the way, gave you those principles? And how do you use that with your nonprofit organization with the kids?
Well, I would have to say that I experienced a lot of childhood trauma in my life. And so having music as an outlet for me and something for me to focus on and really hone in to sort of take my mind off of the tragic events in my life that helped me get to where I am today. And, you know, my mother, God rest her soul, she knew that I had a gift early on. And so she really focused on, I'm going to help you develop this. And I remember telling her when I was younger, I just want to go outside and play. I don't want to practice piano. I don't want to do this. I don't want to sing like that. And she said, no, you're going to thank me when you're older. And I do. I have to thank her because she knew what she was doing and really preparing me for what, you know, platform God was going to place me on in my life. And so when you talk about how, you know, it relates to my organization, well, it's just that, you know, sometimes people have situations in their life that really deter them and take them off track of what their assignment is and what their purpose is in life. And my heart is for young people because, you know, they have a future, but a lot of times their circumstances prevent them from living out that purpose and having an opportunity to express their gifts, express their talent, you know, both musically and athletically, because that component of my organization is based on my husband's life and what he's gone through and how he used sports to bring out, you know, the best in him and to help him exceed in life. And so, you know, I think about young people like myself who've lost parents when they were young, and not everybody can go through grief in a way where they overcome. Sometimes grief, you know, shatters people. Everybody grieves differently. And, you know, some young people have experienced, you know, abuse, rape, molestation. Those are things that I've experienced in my life, unfortunately. But having music there for me to really use as an outlet, I think helped me grow and helped me walk into, you know, my gift and my purpose. And so I wanted to provide an opportunity for other young people who their struggle, who their, you know, the life situation suppress that gift, but knowing that that gift could be the one thing that really allows them a chance at life, I want to be the one to help them accomplish that.
Awesome. Beautiful. Well, you know, I didn't get a chance to read your whole bio. I just went with the first one. But if anybody want to see it, I'll make sure I publish that on our website. But it's so awesome. Your journey, your music journey has been remarkable. I know you mentioned the secular world was a little bit more successful for you because you were on season 3 of NBC's The Voice. And, of course, you had a chance to get picked up by Adam Levine. So tell us about that experience.
Honestly, it's so funny, but I'll give you the short response. That was an incredible experience, but, you know, I always tell this testimony because it was a natural experience, but there was also a spiritual experience to my being on The Voice. And I know this is a gospel radio station, and, you know, so I feel that I can, you know, talk about how God works, but with being on the show, it was a platform that introduced me to a whole nother group of people that never knew of Michelle Brooks Thompson. And so I took that opportunity as a stepping stone for myself, at the advice of the producers. You know, they told us that it doesn't matter if you win or lose. Is what you make of this opportunity. So you can do this show, you can get on a team, and you can go back home and do nothing. You don't maximize on it. Or you can do the opposite. Use this as a launching pad for your career and whatever other endeavors you have in the music industry. And so for me, you know, I got to The Voice because of all the things that I had done prior. And it was a talent scout that referred me for a private audition with the show. And so going there, you know, I went through a different process than what some of the other contestants, you know, or hopefuls do in the beginning. They have, you know, the open call. But it was because of all the things that I had done that led me to The Voice. And so after The Voice, it was like, okay, now I add that to my resume of, you know, prestigious opportunities that I've had. And, you know, although I didn't win, I always believed that that wasn't God's will or his intention for me. But everything concerning The Voice has worked together for my good to carry out his purpose in my life.
Amen. That's right. Awesome. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Patrice, you still there?
Hello?
Okay. We still here,
Patrice? Yes, I'm here.
All right. I was listening. You know how
I was listening to what you said, how you went on that you used it, you know, you were a finalist and you used it to advance your career. And I think sometimes when people say, like, planting the seed, that's kind of like planting the seed, you know, and doing what you can. And what they say in the natural, and God put on the supernatural. So, like, what are some of the other things that you've done and you're doing? So I know you're an actress and you're an author and things like that.
Man, I guess, you know, they say the hustle is real, the grind is real. But, you know, I won't say I'm hustling because I believe that everything in my life is orchestrated by God. And, you know, there's always that natural component where, you know, you're doing things. But sometimes I believe that God can whisper your name to people who, you know, ordinarily probably wouldn't even have heard of you, but somehow something happens, your name is mentioned, or they come across you and, you know, they learn of you, and God may place it in their heart to reach out to you. Because I can say a lot of things in my life have concerning my music, concerning what I've done, has been by divine intervention. And, you know, even now, some of the things that I'm doing, other than a single, I am a finalist for Amateur Night at the Apollo.
Oh, wow.
This year. And so I've advanced. I've won every round, and so now I go on to the Super Top Dog Finals, which is November 22nd at the Apollo Theater in New York City for a grand prize of $20,000. So, you know, the stakes are high,
yeah.
And I have so many supporters that are coming to, you know, cheer me on because, you know, it's all done by cheers from the applause of the audience and all that. But also, you know, with my other piece of my bio with the national anthem, I travel and I do performances of the national anthem for major league sports. And so that's all a part of, you know, my ministry, going to churches and different events to just share my gift.
Yeah,
so I'm kind of all over the place.
That's right, I see. So at the Apollo, are you performing gospel music, or are you doing like Whitney Houston music? Because I know that's your
I'm
specialty.
Actually doing Whitney Houston.
Yeah.
I am doing Whitney Houston songs.
That's right. You can sing that. You can win some events because they hard on you if you mess up a Whitney song.
They are, and you know, I've sort of been consistent with my performance at the Apollo, and I've done Whitney, and, you know, I've received standing ovations
wow.
at the Apollo, and that's tough.
Yeah, it is.
Standing ovations.
Yeah, we were just by there. Did they still televise their talent shows?
They do it through, I believe, with the Top Dog, the Super Top Dog Finals. I believe Coca-Cola sponsors it. And they air it maybe on like their Apollo channel, YouTube, or the playback.
Mm-hmm.
I know they go live the day of the Super Top Dog final.
Oh, wow. So it is on YouTube? So we can find it on YouTube? Oh, I got to do that. Oh, man.
Have Instagram. They have a Twitter. So they will be live that day, backstage, recording, talking to the contestants and, you know, revealing who won and talking to the winner after.
Wow, did not know that. Because we, you know, we were so used to him coming on, what was it, Saturday night for so many years with Sandman. Wow. And it's funny, as many times I had traveled to New York to see my grandmother, that was the first time I went by the Apollo was just last year, last July. We went by there to take pictures. There, nothing was going on that night, but we went by there to see it. And my grandmother didn't live that far from it. It was like a few blocks. I was like, God, oh, everything was right there. It didn't take long to get anywhere.
Yeah,
nice restaurants and everything. Beautiful area. I'm gonna miss it. She passed away this March, so probably won't be getting there no time soon. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, we was traveling up there for the Harlem Book Fair every year, and then hanging out and, you know, spend time with her. So that was like a, you know, a little summertime trip. So yeah, we're gonna miss that. Miss her too. All right. We appreciate you being here, though. Before you go, would you mind giving us your final thoughts and pray for us? Could you do that?
Oh, yes. You know, I always appreciate every platform that, you know, gives an opportunity for me to share my ministry, you know, because a lot of times, you know, artists can get to a place where they feel like, you know, they are deserving of certain things, and it, you know, there's no humility left because they've had a few accolades and a few awards and stuff. But I never feel like that. So I definitely want to be the one that came back to Jesus to thank him for his, you know, his healing. So yes. I always extend my appreciation and gratitude to any radio station, to any media outlet that let Michelle talk a little bit about what she's doing and play a little bit of my song, even if it's 30 seconds or the full thing. So I thank you so much for tonight and just allowing me to come onto your territory and talk to your listeners. And I do pray an abundance of God's blessings and favor on you because, you know, there's not many people that can put themselves last and allow other people to go before them.
Yeah.
And, you know, as a woman of God or a man of God, a person of God's spirit, that's something that we have to do. We have to humble ourselves and know that God will raise us up.
That's right.
And so I pray that blessing over your station and everything that you both do in your life.
Thank you. Amen. All right.
Very welcome. Thank you.
You're welcome. All right. So that was your final thought.
Good night, everybody.
So that was your final thoughts and your prayer. All in one one sitting, right? We appreciate it.
Yes.
All right. Thank you so much, Michelle. Man, I wish we can get up to New York that day. I hope you remember to announce that with us. Please keep us in mind. We on the air all the time. You know, hit us up on Facebook and say, hey, we're going to be in New York. Anybody in the area, you know, we'll see what the weather like. You know, we might get back.
I will send you the event invite that's on Facebook that people have been responding to from, you know, New York, New Jersey, everywhere that are coming to the show.
Yeah. Wow. Top Dog semifinals. Ooh.
Yes.
So you have won a lot of awards. I'm looking at your bio, the competition and everything. So, and one thing I wanted to say, I see you were in Baltimore. You visited the Empowerment Temple with Pastor Jamal Bryant. Yes. Awesome. When was that?
Yeah.
How long ago was that?
That was in October 2014 for their annual women's conference. And I did three services there. And the people from Empowerment Temple are incredible. Their minister of music, Mr. Eugene Brown, they were so welcoming and loving and genuine.
Yeah.
And, you know, I have to say this because I was selling CDs and I ran out.
Oh, wow.
And people just began to sew into my ministry. They were like, here you go. Don't even worry about it. We just want to sew into you. And like I said, you know, that's a blessing when people just sew into you because they believe your ministry.
Mm-hmm. This is a gospel town right here, and we're starting to meet a lot of independent artists now for some of the events that's starting to happen. you know, before it was like we had to travel to find people, but looked like, because even Kevin Lee does an event here, and he introduces a lot of gospel. I didn't hear from him this year. He normally does something during the summer, but he's doing a talk show now, so I'm not sure if he got around it. I'm going to have to reach out to him, because I did have some footage for him, but it didn't turn out as well as I thought, so I pretty much lost contact with him. But, yeah, we're going to reach out to him, see what else he has planned coming up for the gospel artist, because that was a pretty good event, too. All right, Michelle Brooks.
Let me know.
I'm sorry.
Just let me know so I can follow that event.
Yeah.
See what's going on there.
Yeah, well, it's a number of things going to be going on in the area, and if you open to travel, or you can be coming this way. Now, you're living where right now?
I live in Springfield, Massachusetts.
Oh, okay. You're up north. Okay, so I was going to say, if you're traveling to get to New York, but you're not passing this way. So if any chance you're in this area, let us know. We see if we can find a platform for you so we can work with you. You know, we do film and live streaming and everything. So if you got anything booked in this area between, you know, Maryland, D.C., Virginia, let us know.
Yeah, I'm actually going to be in Maryland October 14th for Temple Hill. I think that's
Temple
what it's
Hill,
called.
Maryland. Yeah, it's not too far. Yeah, check in on me, see what we got planned. That date doesn't sound familiar to me. So I'm not sure if I'm booked for anything. But yeah, let's talk about that this week. Okay.
All right.
Cool. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that was Michelle Brooks Thompson, winner of everything, and still more to accomplish. Still more to accomplish. Thank you so much. All right,
Thank
everybody.
You so much.
You're welcome. All right, everybody, we still working. We waiting on Ms. Ursula, which I think she is in the queue right now. So we're going to bring her out in a minute. But while we got Michelle Brooks just finished up, we're going to play her song again, I Am Triumphant, for those who are just coming into the queue. Facebook Live, hello, everybody. Thank you for tuning in. You just heard from Michelle Brooks Thompson. You know, she's like a winner of everything, and we just wish her the best. You know, sometimes that happens when you're torn between the successful secular music versus gospel, because it moves a little slower. But I think now, with the radio stations uniting and coming together, thanks to Ngara and all the other podcasters that are growing, and of course, we got to give praise to Minstrel Appointed for what she's trying to do with the people who spin the music. Putting us on a platform, we give the artists an opportunity to find out who we are if they don't already know. And I think Ngara is doing a wonderful thing. So shout out to Pastor Keith Ron Powell and First Lady Teresa Powell for what they're doing. Because if you remember, they're actually distributing music to over 400 radio stations, both terrestrial and internet. And of course, internet radio is taking on its own animal. As you know, a lot of FM stations are starting to close down, and they're starting to become Amber Alerts. And the same thing with AM. They're not really reaching out as far. The signal's not as good. A lot of the car manufacturers are not even really thinking about using AM FM dials anymore. Everything is going to be USB connection, Bluetooth, all the satellite radio. So it's going that direction now. So your smartphone is everything. So your car is, if you can afford to get a new car this day, they're pretty expensive. But they have all the bells and the whistles to make your listening pleasure more enjoyable. All right, well, here we go. Let's check her out. And again, this is Michelle Brooks Thompson. I Am Triumph.
The battle may be raging, trouble all around. You're crying out to Jesus for a way out. Hold to your faith, finish the race He's already made. Your way of escape, you are triumphant, you are a winner. You're not defeated, you've already You have a victory. You're not a failure. You've only just begun. If you only knew God has
Hi, this is Angel Sessions, and when I'm in town, I listen to Jerry Royce Live, PositivePower21.org, where they play my favorite music.
You are listening to Jerry Royce Live, Worldwide Podcast.
All right, you tell them Angel Sessions and Robot. That's right, you're listening to Jerry Royce Live, Worldwide XXI. Don't forget, this Friday, we're going to be at the CD release party for Michael Tornado 418. J. Nicole Jones is going to be hosting from Fox Sports 1480 Echoes of Glory, which she hosts up in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. We're looking forward to hanging out with that gang on Friday night, starting at 7 o'clock. More information, go out to Michael Tornado's Facebook page. Then on Saturday, we're going to be at Live Again Art Bar in Cambridge, Maryland, across the Chesapeake Bay. That's right, beautiful country. We're going to be out there with Jermaine Anderson. He have a live gospel concert going on. We'll be streaming that live for you at the Art Bar on High Street. So come on by and say hi to me. And then we'll be back in Baltimore in the Windsor area to visit For Better or Worse, the stage play by Battle Stage Plays Presents. It's going to be a special dinner theater performance. And that's going to be on Saturday, the 26th and the 27th. You come say hi to Jerry Royce Live on the 27th. All right. Well, we actually have Miss Ursula Battle here today. She's joining me and Patrice Jackson. What's up, Miss Battle? How are you tonight?
I'm doing great. And how are you?
I'm doing fine. I know you're working hard. You got your grind on. Man, still working. How was it tonight?
Yeah, we still working.
How did it go? You happy? You ready?
Excellent. Yeah. We ready.
Right.
We looking forward.
It's good. Exciting. Can't wait. All right. So you got the big play going. Everybody's ready to go. Saturday and Sunday. Tell us a little bit about it. You know, for those who don't know anything about For Better or Worse.
Well, For Better or Worse is a dinner theater presentation that we'll be doing, as you mentioned, on Saturday and Sunday. And we're actually bringing this piece back by popular demand. We did it back in February of this year for my church, the church that I attend, New Life Fellowship Worship Center. And it was a sellout success, and people enjoyed it. And so we're going to do it again. But basically, it is a story about two grandmothers, or actually two mothers, who make a bet as to whether or not their children are going to get married. And an interesting thing about this particular vet and these two women are that they attend the same church. And they used to be best friends, but there was something that occurred in the past that made them become sworn enemies. Ooh. So in order for your listening audience to find out what happened to cause this rift between the two, they have to come see the play to find out. But it is a hilarious comedy.
Awesome. Awesome.
Very funny.
All right, so tell us about this location. Now, I'm looking at two addresses. So is the church called One God, One Thought Center? Is that correct?
Yes, it's the One God, One Thought Center for Better Living. And the church is located at 3605 Coronado Road, and that is in the Windsor Mill area of Baltimore, Maryland.
Okay, so is that off of Windsor Mill Road? Is that right?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, well, it actually runs off of Liberty Road,
mm-hmm.
but it's right near Washington Avenue.
Oh, Washington Avenue. So that's like Pikesville. I mean, Milford, right? More like
yes,
Milford.
And a landmark that I like to use is that it's right near Milford Mill High School.
Oh, get out of here. Wow.
Mm-hmm.
That's real close. I've never seen that building before. I'm always, that's my ride to work. That's a route I take for you. I have to look for that street. Okay, so it must be on the back. So what you like, if you're coming from, what's that street? Milford, and you make a left on Washington, so it's a left off of Washington, once you get past the speed cameras?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, it is.
It is a lot
back
there.
It's a little hidden. It's a little hidden because it's the church is at the end of a residential street. So once you make that turn on Coronado Road, you take it on around, and the church will be all the way at the end of the street. Just, you know, runs into Liberty Road, but like I said, it's a one-way running out of 250 Road.
Wow, I did not know that. I know there was some buildings back mm-hmm. up in there. I never had reason to go up in there before. All right, awesome. Okay. Now, like when we were talking at the Newsom Award, I mentioned to you that we were so used to hearing about your plays being at Johns Hopkins. Now, I thought I saw a flyer that you're coming back. Are you gonna be back in the Johns Hopkins building soon?
Yes, we're gonna be back at Johns Hopkins in December, December 16th, 17th, and 18th.
Okay.
For a presentation of a very powerful play. That we will be presenting called Serenity House, Ursula mm-hmm. V. Battle's Serenity House. And that is a wonderful piece that really, I'm very excited about it. It is a piece that centers around addiction.
Mm.
But more importantly, it centers around not only addiction, but being delivered from addiction and overcoming addiction. So we believe that people who are struggling with any form of addiction can actually come see this play and really, you know, have their minds transformed and see a way out of their addiction. So we believe that this is a powerful piece that will really deliver people. I mean, it is really something to behold and something I'm very excited about. And one of the things that really excites me is the fact that through a stage play, we could do so many things. Mm-hmm. And so the fact that, you know, there's such a strong spiritual component in that piece that I believe that, you know, will help so many people that are struggling with addiction and give them hope really, really excites me.
Yeah, awesome. Okay. All right. Patrice, you got a question for Ms. Battle?
I was listening to can you hear me?
Yeah, we hear you.
Oh, I was just listening to about the play, and then other ones that's coming up. If you could tell me about maybe one or two of the characters that's going to be in the play.
For better or worse?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. Well, the two characters I mentioned earlier, the two mothers who have this little bet going, there's one mother. Her name is Sister Two-Face. And then there's another character. Her name is Sister Snooty Snooty.
Snooty
so
Snooty.
These characters in the play represent those things that I guess you could say, are characteristic of them as people. So Sister Two-Face, her name is Two-Face, but they call her Sister Two-Face. So she's called Sister Two-Face because she actually is two-faced.
Mm.
She says one thing and she does another. On the other side with Sister Snooty, she's very conceited, you know, very snooty, very, very stuck up.
Mm.
And so that is her character. And if I could just mention very quickly some of the other characters in the play, and let me just make one other point. This play and these characters represent the things that a marriage needs to have in order to stay intact. Marriages, friendships, any kind of relationship.
Mm-hmm.
And on the other side, there are characters in this play that represent those things that will drive a relationship or marriage apart. So on the side in which we're talking about those characters that represent the bad things, we have a character named Gaspar Gertrude. Well, she gossips all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have another character. His name is Lion King. He lies all the time. and then we have Mr. and Mrs. Unequally Yoked on that side. And then they're on the, you know, that's just three of, you know, some of the bad characters, some of the things that we need to stay away from to keep our marriages and relationships together.
That's right.
You know, you need to avoid those things. We have another character. Her name is Adulterous Anna. And we have Fornicating Fred. You know, all these things that oftentimes drive marriages apart.
Mm.
But then there are those things that you have to have in a marriage or relationship in order for it to stay together.
Yeah.
So we have, of course, at the top is God. You have to have God in your relationship and in your marriage in order for it to stay together. That's the key.
That's right.
So we have Reverend Righteous, and we have Constance Communication, who represents communication in a relationship. We have a character named Honesty Harriet. She represents having honesty in a relationship. We have Mr. and Mrs. Equally Yoked. So again, these characters all represent the good things that we need to have and those bad things that we need to stay away from in order to keep our marriages together.
That's right.
So, you know, through those characters and certainly a lot of comedy, I mean, there's some very powerful lessons in this particular piece. Definitely has a ministry message to it, definitely a spiritual message to it. But it is truly a very hilarious play, and I think people are going to come out, they're going to get the message. I think they'll be blessed with a very important message, but they'll have a good belly whopping time, you know, in terms of laughing, and we'll walk away with not only that, I think a belly full of food, because we have a delicious menu lined up for this, a catered dinner by Baltimore's own Charm City Caterers.
Yeah.
So they'll get fellowship and food. And a wonderful, wonderful time.
Yeah, can't wait. That sounds exciting.
Oh,
now, now, you got a chance to name all the name of the characters. Can you name a few of the actors and actresses that's in the play? Give them a shout out.
Sure. Well, let me first start out with our wonderful director, Dr. Gregory William Branch.
Yeah.
Excellent director. So Dr. Branch and I, you mentioned Hopkins earlier. We, you know, partner on a lot of things down at Johns Hopkins. And so I'm just blessed to be working with Dr. Branch again. And in terms of some of the performers, we have Leonard and Yvonne Stepney. We also have Minister Curl Williams. We also have a gentleman by the name of Brian Stevenson. We have a young lady by the name of Tanya Brown. I mean, we have about 40 people in the cast, so I can go on and on, but what I will say is that we just have a wonderful, talented cast of people. And through these productions, I just thank God for giving me an opportunity to showcase and put on display all of the wonderful talent that we have here in Baltimore.
Yeah. Wow, that's a big cast, 45. Wow.
It's a huge cast.
It is. Well, I'm looking forward to it. I'm excited. So y'all and everybody, remember, Jerry Royce Live Worldwide, a.k.a. Batman, will be on the road this weekend, starting with Friday. with Michael Tornado and J. Nicole Jones. So they be here in the Baltimore area on Saturday. We be going over to the Chesapeake Bay area, Cambridge, Maryland, with Live Again Art Bar. It's a live gospel concert. We be streaming that live. Then we be back in Baltimore on Sunday to interview all the people that's coming out of the play and get their responses and and get a chance to network with some of the actors and actresses. So it's going to be awesome. So we're looking forward to it. And that's at One God, One Thought Center for Better Living, starting at 3 o'clock on Sunday when I'm there. And the rest of the week is Saturday is 1 o'clock and a 6 o'clock show. You go to her website at www.battlestageplays.com. All right. And I can't wait to meet with you. So, you know, we're going to have to set that up, too, so we can make sure we get our sit down together and talk about our future together, see how we can, you know, do some business. All right. Sound good?
That sounds good. Sounds good. And thank you for taking the opportunity to, you know, share your time with me and your show with me. And I, you know, I always believe that, you know, when I get an opportunity to meet people like yourself, that it is arranged by God. And so I just thank God for bringing us together. And again, I just, you know, thank you for your time and, you know, providing us with this type of exposure. I truly consider it a blessing.
Yeah, you're welcome. And we're going to work again together. So, you know, it's not the end. So we appreciate you allowing us to be part of what you're doing. It's awesome. We heard so much about
you. Thank you. You're welcome.
All right. That's Ursula Battle. Don't forget, check her out at www.battlestageplays.com. I remember one year, I think it might have been a year or two ago, my cousin Zenobia Sampson had a play at the Senior Citizen Place over in Forest Park, Liberty. And I got there and I said, all these people lined up around this building. I must be at the wrong place. Man, I said, the play here? And they said, yeah. I said it wasn't enough room for all those people. And I said, how y'all find out about it? And they said internet radio. They said we heard it on your show. So that just tells you, shows,
awesome.
Yeah, people pay attention. People support you in Baltimore. They were supporting, and I bet you she didn't even know half those people that went in there. That's how it's supposed to be. Support your brothers and your sisters. That's how we create jobs around here. You know
they do. They do. I'm grateful. I'm grateful. I'll just say this real quickly that we have been blessed to be filling out show after show, and this particular presentation is well on its way to being another sellout. Mm-hmm. And I just thank God because he's blessed me with people that continue to support us. I mean, we wouldn't be able to do this without people coming out and supporting us time and time again. And so we have a loyal group of supporters that come out and see, you know, what we're doing. Mm-hmm. And they attend, and not only do they attend, they bring people. And then those people they bring come back, and they come back, and so the word has really spread. And so I just like to just thank the people that continue to support me time and time again. And I'll tell you this, I have people that call me sometimes and just say, you know, Ms. Battle, what do you have coming up next? I'm ready for another play. I mean, what you working on? So I said, wow, you know. And so I just want to just thank everybody that just believes in the vision that we have in the ministry of these plays, and just point out that we would never be able to do it without their support. So I'm grateful for that.
Yeah, awesome. Is Pamela Hill, is she in the play, Pamela Hill?
Pamela Hill, a.k.a. Miss Maybell, is in this play. Uh-oh. She plays a character. Her name is Sister Loveless.
Ooh,
and
God.
You have to see why they call her Sister Loveless by coming and seeing this place.
Oh, my
it's
God.
Hilarious.
She is crazy. That lady is so funny. Oh, man. Oh. Oh, God. I hope I get a chance to watch the play. I know I'm going to be set up in the hallway, but I hope I get a chance to peep some of those scenes. Oh, my, wow.
I sure hope so. Yeah. I sure hope so.
Well, I got to give you a call tomorrow anyway, because that was a couple of things I wanted to ask you before, you know, before I pull my camera out. I wanted to make sure it was okay with you first.
Okay.
All right. All right, Ms. We got to have
that
you on as a guest. You got to come on as a guest. I know you just came on tonight just to promote the show and everything, but we got to get you come on so people know how you got your start, you know, how many plays you're deep into, and, you know, how you developed into the person you are right now, you know, a playwright. So we got to get you on after this is over, okay?
You just let me know. You let me know when, and I love talking about that journey and how I believe God is utilizing me as a vessel.
Mm-hmm.
do these plays to, you know, to get his word out and to encourage people. So I always like to talk about that. So whenever you're ready for me to do that, you let me know, and I will be where you need me to be to make that happen.
All right. I'll send it to your admin. I know your admin called me today. I said, wow, she's so important. She got an administrator making calls for her. I like that. She said, hold on, Miss Battle want to speak to you. Wow.
Thank you.
So official.
Thank you.
All right. All right, everybody. So, like I said, everybody, tune in. I'm going to be streaming the other two events. Of course, we won't be able to stream the stage play, but we will be able to stream the other two events on Friday and Saturday. So tune in and catch the interviews from Miss Battle's play when we run them on, I guess, running Sunday night. You get a chance to check out what people are saying about Miss Battle's plays. All right, Patrice. Did you feel the power, Patrice Jackson? Did you feel the power?
I feel the power.
Yeah, it was a powerful night. Man, you know, first I thought I was going to have Miss Ursula on at first. I had a feeling she probably going to be caught up in production and everything. But it was so great that she had a chance to talk for almost 30 minutes about what she's doing. So, man, it's good to have a connection in your own town, you know? I'm always on the road.
Yes, she's doing a lot of good things in your in the city.
Yeah, she's only like, that's like 5-10 minutes from my studio. You know, I can actually.
Oh, wow. Late.
Yeah, it's no big, I don't have to get on the road. Leave 2 hours early. Yeah, it's awesome. Yeah, I think she told me I need to be there at 2 o'clock, so I could leave like 4:45 and be early. Yeah, just like the Newsman Ward. That was like 10 minutes. Matter of fact, it was pretty close to the place where she is right now. Yeah, awesome. Can't wait. Can't wait to check it out. Check it out. Yeah, new connection, man. We got to do that. And I promise you guys, I told you I was going to get out of these four walls. And God's been good. He's been leading me to some great people here in the city. And I'm just so excited, you know, as a radio owner. You know, I'm really happy, especially dealing with you guys. You know, I got to thank you guys. You, Kimmy Kim, Tina, and Michelle, Joyce, and Paula, and me and Paula been talking too. We got some great things going on for Paula, the voice. So we excited.
Yeah, Paula was just on my show. It was a great interview.
Oh yeah, I got to listen to. I got to catch that show for tomorrow. So make sure you send me that link because I know it's on my network somewhere. I got to look for that because sometimes Tina's stuff don't always come over all the time because I think cause she's streaming on Spreaker now. Where before you guys on Blog Talk, I was getting everything. Now I got to wait till she send me stuff. So yeah, I'll check that out tomorrow. So we're excited about it. And I know Superwoman got some big stuff planned, too. I know she's talking to Praise Orlando. You know, Jeffrey's really excited about what's going on. We bring a lot of urban radio, Christian contemporary podcasting over to his network, and he's really excited about this because, you know, he has the access to a dynamic network, and he's looking for really, really good shows. So if you guys, anybody out there looking for some good engineering, Double XI is offering engineering. You're looking for a big platform for to do your talk radio. You know, check us out. We have everything here, as you can see. This is what this is for. It's not just for me. It's just not my toy, but it's available for anybody looking for you know, a real quality radio system. That's right. All you gotta do is just call in and you're on the radio. All right. Well, Patrice, time to get out of here. We already felt the power. So it's time for us to close out. And we appreciate everybody. You mind praying us out, Patrice? I know Michelle gave us a prayer. Will you mind praying for us tonight? For all our listeners, everybody tuning in tonight?
I will. Now, my phone is still a bit. It's about to kind of low, but we'll happily do it.
All right. Thank you so much.
So, Lord, I just want to thank you for bringing us all together. We had a jam-packed, awesome, special show. Got to speak to some very creative people. You have blessed with awesome, amazing gifts. Lord, so you just continue to bless them and keep filling them up and filling us up, Lord. Just keep giving us the strength and the ability and the power, Lord, to continue to follow you and to continue to do what you want us to do. Lord, we love you so much. We thank you for all you have done and all you're going to do for us, the listeners, and all the guests. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. You know what, Patrice, you were right. Those three individuals, I mean, that was some massive talent and gifts that was on the show tonight.
Yeah.
You talking about Mr. Appointed, CEO of a magazine, now CEO of a award show that's probably going to be a knockout. And then, plus she's a gifted, you know, anointed singer, performer, and a pastor. A lot of people didn't know that about her. She's actually a pastor. And she's so funny too. My wife just love her to death. My wife said she is so funny. I said, I know, she's a trip. And then Michelle Brooks Thompson, superstar. She is really a superstar in her own right. And we hope everything work out for her to pile. I'd like to be there too, man. I want that experience. I gotta talk to my wife. I gotta talk to my honey about the Invisible Girl. I wanna go to that. Road trip. But they ain't gonna let me shoot inside the Apollo. But maybe I get some selfies with some people. Yeah, I'm putting that on my count. I gotta beat it. What she said, the 26th? November 26th. I gotta hit her back up. I'm going to that. That's been my dream, to be on the Apollo. Not necessarily on the stage, but I wanna be part of that. Yeah, I wanna be there. Yeah, I've been in New York this whole summer. Alright, we ready to get out of here, y'all. All right, Patrice, you said you felt the power. Tell him you felt the power.
I felt the power.
She felt the power. You hear that, Danny Hudson? She felt the power, Mr. Appointed. Colton McConnell. I got it right. Then Michelle Brooks Thompson. Sharika. What's up, Sharika? Did you feel the power? Did you feel it? Appreciate everybody joining us tonight. All my guests, thank you for joining us. Mr. Tony, he was out there. Dana Phil stopped by. She's going to be on the show real soon. Orlando, thank you for coming by. Frank Chase came through. And I'm sorry I didn't have enough time to talk about Frank Chase Project. He's one of our sponsors coming on board. Hopefully we have his stuff ready. I didn't even have the script ready. But we have his stuff ready for Friday night on the Quiet Storm with Paula G and Jerry Royce Live Worldwide, a.k.a. Batman. Join us on the Quiet Storm, y'all, at midnight. We'll be on right after we finish up with Michael Tornado. 7 o'clock, join us. We'll be streaming live, y'all. All right, let's get out of here. Don't forget, y'all, we'll be back Friday night at midnight, Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday.
Hi, this is Angel Sessions. When I'm in town, I listen to Jerry Royce Live, PositivePower21.org, where they play my favorite.
You tell them, Angel. That's right, y'all. I'll be back Thursday, y'all. We got more special guests for you on Thursday. We'll send a promo out just to remind you guys. Reed was supposed to be here, but we're going to reschedule her. I think she's coming back next week. She actually going to be performing. We get excited for her. We can't wait to get her on the show. All right, everybody. Peace out.
This is Brandon Royce, and you're listening to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide on PositivePower21.org.
I'm Superwoman Tina Hobson, and you are listening to Late Night with Jerry Royce Live.
This is my now, now I can dream again. No longer a chain holding me. This is my now, no longer living in fear again. Now I can see. I can hear. This is mine now. This is my now. Now I can dream again. No longer I change. Holding me, I'm walking out my destiny. This is my now, no longer living in fear again. No longer bound by the opinion of men. Now I can hear God again. This is mine now. For faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. My keys will bring me before. This is mine now, now I can dream again. No longer are chains holding me. I'm walking now, my destiny. This is mine now, no longer living in fear again. No longer bound by the opinion of men. Now I can hear God again. This is mine.
Your host, East Coast, West Coast, we're gonna party in the name of Jesus. The Holy Ghost is now officially in hip-hop. Not only have I been elected, but your boy worked hard. Now I'm the first bishop of hip-hop. Let's go, drop low, yeah. He said if you desire the office of a bishop, you desire it for good work. So my G.O.D.s, we got work to do. We got some spirits to chop up, and we got some demons to kill. Yeah, drop low, let's go, drop low, let's go, ain't no room for the enemy, show him how to bounce. Stomp the devil out, stomp the devil out. Ain't no need for the enemy, show him how to bounce. Stomp the devil out, stomp the devil out. Stomp the devil out, stomp the devil out. Stomp the devil out, stomp the devil out. Yeah, we gon' take it up to God, yeah, uh-huh. You rockin' with me in the name of Jesus. Y'all ready? Yeah. We gon' give it to God now. Yeah. Little kids having babies. Stomp the devil out. Stomp the devil out. Stomp the devil out. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Drop low. Drop low. Drop low. Drop low. Little boys selling crack. Stomp the devil out. Stomp the devil out. Stomp the devil out. Pull your pants up, boy. Stomp the devil out. Stomp the devil out. Stomp.
do it again, repent. I never do it again. This is pity nature, me preach and repent, repent. I never do it again, repent. I never do it again. You rock with pity nature in the name of Jesus. And this is the dance. Stop the devil out. Oh.